friends with Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting Rain to episodes 15 and 16 of Magical Girl Lyrical. None will have strikers. Let's go ahead and get started with episode 15 in 3, 2, 1, go. My freaking ears. Let's get down to business. Makes the most sense. You're probably gonna be really sleepy now. And see, she's not holding back, even though that's her sister. Ooh. Yeah, with the bare hand too. Ooh, very close. And also watch out for each other. Ain't that a little unfair? I mean, five against four, but I don't think that's unfair at all. I mean, but you know, they'll find a way around it. Oh, there's baby. Good job. Yeah, look pretty for your mommies, right? Poor baby, the god they ass beat. You still did good. My God, she's so precious. Goodbye. Goodbye. Well, I mean, in a way, she is Nanoha and Fate's kid. Vivian. Don't. It's okay. Exactly, that's what I was about to say. See, wives and moms. Yes. Baby's over here. Yeah, that's the kid. Can you imagine if she held both of their hands? Oh my God, that would be so fucking cute. Aww. Big behind, boy. Eating for 20. I mean, hey. Yeah, we all did it when we were kids. I gotta eat that. Make it big and strong. She's right. I still don't like him. You say that, but then there will definitely be problems. Come on now. I don't trust her either. I don't know why she make me feel in some type of way. Which is oh, and knock you guys down? Yeah, I mean, because he seems like that. I mean, he seems like the only guy who will only think of himself and not all of you as a whole, because you're all just pawns to him. Oh, my God. I've sat in this chair for far too long. My butt hurts so much. Oh. What's up? See, something also tells me that their weapons, they're coming back to haunt them. Like, so they're, because see, these two are very important for this season. I mean, they're like what Nanoha and Fate used to be like in the previous series. They are the most two important characters in this out of everybody, including Nanoha and Fate. It's just something about them that in the final episodes they're gonna have to do with, or something is about them that will, help against the bad guy. And maybe I could be wrong about that. Hope everything goes well. Hope that you guys don't end up being terminated because nobody wants that. 7 days is a long time from now. I mean, but yeah, something about Subaru and her sister just rubbed me the wrong way, but not in a bad way, more in a good way. It's just like they seem like they're going to be the ones who are going to be that quote unquote key, maybe. And I could be wrong about it, as I said. I mean, there have been times where I've been wrong and wrong before in any of the anime series that I've reacted to and such. But at the same time, it's very interesting to have this episode where, yeah, her and her sister are able to hang out. But at the same time, you're looking at the sister and the girl with the green hair a little side-eyed, especially with what happened last week. And them discussing it with their chief. And I'm like, yeah, don't really trust him. Can't really trust y'all. Don't know how I feel. But anything can happen between the next few weeks to whatever. But most definitely, yeah. Oh, what the fuck that they're showing her as a baby? And oh my god, yes, because Nanoha has grown so much. But yeah, Nanoha and Fate being the two mommies that they are, wives and mommy to Vivial and the rest of their kids, it's just adorable as fuck. Like any moment that they have where they're just being moms and being like a guardian to them is really adorable. I really just truly love that about the series. I mean, not only in general, where it's like you see a lot of animes coming out now where it's like a child who was quote unquote an orphan. Oh my god. And the child is being adopted by either like two dads, two moms, and such, and gets a really interesting family. It's really sweet and adorable. Yep, this is where shit gets bad. This is where shit gets bad. Of course it's a part. I don't like the fact that it's a parter episode. Oh my God. That means it might be a two or three parter. Jesus Christ. Oh, I understand why we're doing it, but still. But this is where Ish is about to go down and secrets, all the little things, every little thing that probably people don't want to come to light. Oh, it's probably coming to light, but we gotta wait and see. Go ahead and pause the video, and I will see you guys in 1 second for episode 16. Okay, episode 16 in 3, 2, 1, go. Feel like that too, but something's gonna happen where you are not gonna be invincible. And this is where it gets bad. Where shit gets real. That too. Oh, baby. You'll have feet, Mama. The feeling in the pit of my stomach is coming. Something bad is coming. Yes, I'm not ready. No. Yeah, but you might as well just adopt her at the end of the day. Right? She's super attached to you and Fate. We'll see how that goes. Just like you. The fact that they gotta do it all freaking night. Bruh, I couldn't do it. This is why I could never work in military. This is why I can never do a job that has me being like, hey, you got a 12-hour shift. I got a what? 12. Bruh. Right? Can't always look at the past. Which you might consider that as him being rude or just very secretive. So watch Raising Heart for me. Yeah, pretty much everyone is here. Yet, the key word is yet, baby. True, you are right about that. Have to follow through with those. Ain't that a little weird that she went somewhere to go give her report? That's just me, or it just no one seeing the wrongness about that? Of course, she feels like she owes everything to him because, yeah, he is her savior. But I feel like she's just gonna, every, like, this whole group, I feel like they're just all going to screw each other over. Like, yes, they all are this quote unquote family who are close to each other and want to do everything for each other, but still, him, the doctor, he is screwing over everyone day fucking one. Mark my words. He will screw them all over. He will let them all die in order to save himself. Come on now, look at every other villain that we've seen for this series. Excuse me. God, I ain't coming threes. Don't go right for the towers. Hold the fuck up. You telling me just because you just got caught on fire and right now y'all are being under attack that you're not gonna stop? Boy, could not be me. Could not be me. We're under attack. Time out. We stopping everything. Our oh. And none of y'all have y'all weapons. How are y'all gonna get out? They are the number one priority as of now. Oh, hold up, wait. He said, they said calm down. Sir, no. Panic. Panic mode. Girl, you know fate is gonna go to the end of the world with you. No, no, that's a wife. Once again, the I have a bad feeling about this. So they basically did the same thing that they did. Do not end like that. Okay, thank God. Because, oh. But my thing is, why take one? No, because if they take these 4/3, it'll be vital because of the fact that both Fate and Nanoha has to rescue them. But they won't have Raising Heart or Build a Dash, so they're screwed. They need those in order to just do anything, and without those, once again, screwed. Is this episode concluded next week? Honestly, I have no idea how this is going to go next week. I mean, because Fate and Nanoha, yes, they're going down into the depths of this elevator, leading them, I'm guessing, to either the ground floor or the basement, and eventually they'll run into their kids and such, or you know, maybe the kids will run into Fate and Nanoha. But right now, the kids are currently trapped. They have to fight these two people in order to get past them. But at the same time, then you have Hayate and everyone else stuck in that building. And Hayate's family out in the field doing what they have to do. This is a really, in a moment, like, in my opinion, this is a despair-inducing moment because it's like, damn, our heroes are down, the villains are winning. Like, what else can we truly do? Because, yeah, the villains are winning big time right now in this 2 or 3-parter episode, even though this is only part one. But yes, the the, what I like to call the commander in chief, being over here like, no, we will continue the convention. Boy, if you don't shut up. If it was anybody else finding out they were under attack during anything, especially during a meeting, strategy meeting, whatever, they would stop what they're doing, find a way out, and then do their attack. Then we go onwards to battle so that everyone can get their weapons. But because you're in a tower with no weapons right now, you're screwed. The fuck can you do? Nothing. Ooh, blood about to be spread. No, no, my baby is crying. I'm not ready for next week. That's all I'm going to say. Not ready. You got a child crying. You got Kaido crying. And Subaru is bleeding. I don't like that feeling. We're not going to talk about what I feel like is going to happen. I'm just going to shut up. And we're going to wait until next week, aka tomorrow for me, to see what the fuck is going to happen. But I mean, yeah. Ooh, okay. Damn, Light. Light was just telling me, hey, we done for the night. Like, go ahead and power off. But really, both episodes are very good. I mean, just this episode, in my opinion, was a little bit better. I hope that Vivio will be safe. I don't need anything happening to her because she is also Precious Baby Girl and such. But yeah, right, as I said, the villains are currently winning in this situation of this battle right now. And it's only hopeful, or we hope that Subaru and friends are able to get Fate and Nanoha their weapons quick, fast, in a hurry, which of course is obvious because Fate is transformed in that moment. You just didn't see Nanoha. So signs are going to be, you know, going in the good way of by next week, or really tomorrow for me, that yes, those two will be able to fight. But Hayate, unfortunately, is a no-go because she is still in the towers, and anything that really can and will happen. So it's not only guarding themselves, it's also protecting a tower that has thousands upon thousands of people in it, and anything truly can happen in the next few episodes. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction review towards episodes 15 and 16 of Magical Girl Little Hole Nanoha Strikers. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons. And next Wednesday, I was about to say Monday, for everybody else for episodes 17 and 18. Bye, guys.